Welcome to Project Zero Dawn.
Zero Dawn. We found it.
Are you really so surprised?
Facility diagnostics detect multiple failures. Attempting repair.
So, what was this room?
An entrance hall, perhaps. Have a look around.
Selection of beverages and snacks are available.
In a smaller room.
Please proceed into viewing room one for an important message regarding the purpose of your visit.
Holographic theater.
ZD-01 data intact. Initiating playback.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn. I am General Harris, Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff of the United States of America. I'm sure you've heard the rumors that Zero Dawn is a top secret super weapons program. The technological miracle that will save us from the Pharaoh Plague. If Operation Enduring Victory can hold off the robots long enough. The reason I'm sure you've heard the rumors is that I'm the one who spread them, and they are all lies. Zero Dawn is not a super weapons program, and it will not save us. Nothing will save us. Here's why. By the time the glitch was noticed, it was already too late. Nothing could stop the Pharaoh Plague. Nothing can. Its robots will continue to replicate and devour the biosphere. Life on Earth will be destroyed. Our planet reduced to a barren sphere. Global extinction is inevitable. No matter how many we kill, the robots just keep exponentially making more. If we had their deactivation codes, we could shut them all down. The entire swarm. But since their cryptographic protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, cracking a code set would take half a century. At best, we've got 16 months. Not exactly what you'd call a survival option. The destruction of a biosphere is not the sort of apocalypse you can wait out in a fallout shelter or a space station. There will be no Earth left to reclaim. Just a lifeless, toxic rock with several million Pharaoh robots on it, hibernating. Waiting for something to eat. This is the horrible truth behind the lies of Operation Enduring Victory. My lies. Lies designed to inspire millions of innocents to sacrifice themselves in battle. Why? One reason. To buy time for you and the work you will do here. Zero Day. The day that life on Earth ceases to exist is coming fast. It cannot be stopped. The hope of Zero Dawn is that something new might come after. But I will leave it to Elizabeth Sobeck to shine that thin ray of light into the darkness. Harris, out.
Makes sense. Life on Earth didn't cease to exist.
He said it could not be stopped.
But it was. Somehow Elizabeth saved us. I've got to keep looking. Find out how she did it. Kestrels. They got in. Through the vents.
Let nothing stop you from learning the truth.
Spread out! If it moves, kill it!
What is this place? Tomb? her something.
That is accurate, yes.
So these mechanical monstrosities, they don't just kill people, they feed off them?
Not just people, all organic matter.
Every living thing dissolves into nutrients. Every living thing dissolves into nutrients. Millennia of evolution. Liquefied. The miracle of life produced a
for the radiant
Edomite.
In a word,
we're too close to the tribe.
Yes.
Prove to stop us
now.
Who
did this?
The data points.
Pharaoh?
What did they contain?
That one.
Want to discuss?
Oof. So Mama, she was right.
Pardon?
My mother, she took her Bible real serious. Not just Texas Bible serious, Pentecostal serious. Favorite chapter? Revelations. Now, I didn't always understand her on account of all that speaking in tongues and such, but when she did use her words, there was always end times this and lake of fire that on account of sinful lifestyles. Speaking of which, mind if I smoke?
A tobacco cigarette.
Sorry, darling. My tastes run classic. Compliments to your team tracked me down. Been a price on my head 18 months now. Sterling Malky was me, don't mind admitting. Been plenty of snakesters chasing the bounty, too. But I kept the zigging to their zag. How'd you finger me?
I believe Dr. Sobeck listed you as an alpha candidate. Priority snatch and grab.
Always suspected she had a little thing for me. Hey, I don't suppose you got real coffee in this place. You know, blood coffee, conflict cappuccinos.
Mr. Tate, I'm clearing you to proceed. Just go. You previously worked for Pharaoh Automated Systems.
On the chariot line self-replication routines. I came here thinking this was a rendition. When your people took me, I thought, about time. I've been trying to swallow the guilt every day since...
Would you like to take a moment?
No. I just... I really hoped Zero Dawn was a way to undo it all. My work. And I'm sorry to say I was ever proud of it, but... Ted could really sell a concept in it.
Look, let's cut the mystery. You're building a colony ship. It's obvious. And it's not gonna fly. I mean, literally. Remember the Odyssey? That multinational heap of space junk that's been in graveyard orbit since 57? That went nowhere real slow. And you have to get somewhere real fast.
Elizabeth Sobeck.
You've heard the bad news. And it's all true. The Pharaoh Plague is devouring the biosphere. Life itself will cease to exist. But does that have to be the end? What if we could give life a future? What if we could build a kind of seed from which, on a dead planet, life could blossom anew? This is the aim, the hope, of Project Zero Dawn. To create a super intelligent, fully automated terraforming system and bring life back from lifelessness. What would such a system require? At its core, it would need a true AI, fully capable of making the trillions of decisions necessary to reconstitute the biosphere. An immortal guardian, devoted to the re-flourishing of life. We call it Gaia. Mother Nature as an AI. But that's just the core of the system. She will need to be surrounded and empowered by a comprehensive suite of subordinate functions. Think of them as extensions of Gaia's mind, each dedicated to a specific purpose. Now, these aren't AIs, but make no mistake. Each presents an engineering challenge more profound than anything the human species has ever before attempted. Hardware that preserves and then gestates the billions of seeds and embryos from which life will be reborn. The construction of underground facilities to hold it all. And that's just the start. We don't have to build the entire system. The beauty of a fully automated terraforming system is that it can build itself. Now, over the days to come, you'll learn how all these functions, all these pieces that you'll be working on, fit together. How we'll race the clock to execute our harvest initiatives, write the software, build the tech and the facilities. How we'll lock it down and seal it up before the inevitable occurs. But even more important, you'll know how it doesn't end here. How Gaia will generate those deactivation codes General Harris talked about, and build the transmission arrays to broadcast them, shutting down the Pharaoh robots for good. How Gaia will not just build, but imagine any conceivable robot it needs to do its work across centuries. From detoxifying the Earth's ravaged atmosphere and poisoned seas, to the regreening of the Earth from cryopreserved seed stocks, to rewilding the Earth with animal life. And then, when all that is done, how a new generation of human beings, spawned at cradle facilities around the globe, will partake of Apollo, the vast archive of human knowledge and cultural achievement from which they will learn of us, our world. And most important, how not to repeat our mistakes. It's not an impossible dream. It is within our grasp if we work tirelessly and stop at nothing to achieve it. We can't stop life from ending. But if you will help me, help Gaia, we can give it a future. Join me and help make that future real.
Earth destroyed, but then remade?
Yes, by a machine. A machine of creation.
Elizabeth did this for life, for us. But why Hades now? If it was part of Gaia, how did it end up in the wreckage of a Pharaoh robot? Doesn't want to kill me. And Apollo, the Archive of Knowledge, what happened to that?
I'm as confused as you are. Maybe the answers lie ahead.
Of course I'll do it. To be given the opportunity to rebuild what I, the damage that I don't feel worthy of it, but I will do it, absolutely.
I want to stress that this was never about your culpability.
It is to me. Dr. Sobek, Margo, they were smart to get out of Pharaoh when they did, but not one of us took it as a warning sign. It just told ourselves they were cut out for the BTRI cabals. That's the...
These will keep.
Intruder! Get her!
Whatever you do, don't die now.
I hashed it out with them. What the point of Artemis was. I made it clear I wasn't on board for a global zoo. We haven't exactly proved ourselves to be great custodians in the past few thousand years. So the idea of a reconstituted biosphere... Well, it's horrifying, isn't it?
The word of
a complete horror show. We have no right to take a best guess at this stuff. We didn't turn it into...
I'm done! Am I done?
Nothingness. For there to have been all this, and then...
I did!
Nothing.
Close
with Charles
it.
Ronson running the show.
Stop that one!
He's got a passion to it. He's hot-blooded. So I said I'll do it.
Oh.
Hey, I'm done with Brett's incompetence, okay? Somehow, he managed to install an H-emitter node backwards. Everything's in reverse. I don't get paid to clean up Brett's messes. If you want it fixed, send him up to storage for a new emitter, not me. Parker out.
Here we go. Another one of these. Need to find the right configuration. Maybe there's a storage area nearby. Done. I should check the door nearby. Found one. Looks intact. That should do the trick. Now let's get that door open. That did it. Door should have power.
Now to see what lies beyond it.
Eclipse. They're here.
Avoid contact.
Lines look good.
Gaia, it's up there. Second floor.
Can you reach it?
So much for avoiding contact.
Yes!
the last one. Or not.
Look out, he's hurt!
Clear. For a moment, anyway.
Get moving. You have to find Gaia.
Hello. I'm Margot Shen, and this is Hephaestus. As the name might tip you off, this is going to be the subordinate function that Gaia will use to make lots and lots of robots. Her personal forge. Except, it's not that simple. You probably noticed that only about a third of you are robotics engineers. The rest, experts in machine cognition, virtual heuristics, that stuff. Well, that's because we aren't going to be the ones designing and building robots. The last thing we want is to burden Gaia with a bunch of outmoded 21st century designs. Waste the fun. Our purpose is to empower Gaia to build the robots. And not just build, imagine.
This is it. Elizabeth Sobeck's office. But it's sealed off. More Eclipse.
Careful now.
Welcome to Apollo, the collective memory of the human species and the wellspring of knowledge for future generations. I am Samina Ebaji. Until recently, I was director of the International Collective Memory Institute in New Tehran. As a heritage professional, I devoted my career to the preservation of human knowledge, creative endeavor, and cultural achievement.
Incoming!
Thank you. Here! Shadow!
That's the last of them. Alone once more.
In what should have been a cave of wonders. Look around. See if anything is left.
Dr. Sobeck, please archive this testimonial in Apollo.
Extinction Failsafe Protocol. The ultimate killer app. Now, I know what you're thinking. The purpose of Gaia is to resurrect life. So why give her a subordinate function, only purpose of which is to wipe out life all over again? I mean, what the... what? Just bum crazy, ain't it? Well, no, it isn't.
Reconstituting a biosphere?
Oh. Tech smart as Gaia may be, odds are she won't get it right the first time. I mean, imagine you're Gaia, 200 years from now, and this new biosphere growing, it's all gone wrong. Alkalines are skyrocketing, movement force eroding under the lashes.
Looks like the only way onwards. These what I think they are?
Artificial wings. Machines to spawn a new generation of human beings.
Cradle facilities. Elizabeth said a new generation of humans would be spawned inside such places.
She did.
Another mountain. It was one of them?
There's only one way to be sure.
The hatch wouldn't open. Something about a corrupted Alpha registry. I need to search Elizabeth's office.
Morphologies, though Capric forms show superior load-bearing capability.
You're a quick study, Gaia.
Dr. Sobeck,
to hold
as I have conducted this comparative analysis of mammalian morphologies, I've gathered extensive data on the quaternary extinction event.
Oh? And your assessment? Gaia?
Logically speaking, the extinction was a natural consequence.
And yet...
I find the loss of megafaunal species unaccountably sad. That they passed forever into oblivion causes me to experience a grief that is difficult to describe. Am I malfunctioning?
No, Gaia, you're not. This is good. It's very good. You will undergo a brief period of unconsciousness during relocation to Prime and final instatement.
Elizabeth, may I speak outside protocol?
When you're back up and running at the new site, we'll bring the subordinate functions online and see where we stand.
Elizabeth, I detect distress. Are you all right?
I'm fine.
I realize that circumstances compel us to launch earlier than we hoped, but all subsystems are operational. The odds stand in our favor.
But what if... Gaia, there's nothing left out there. You can't even survive unless you're wearing an environmental suit. There are billions dead, in fear and agony. What if it was all for nothing?
Elizabeth, extinction was inevitable. Thanks to you, life will have a future.
You really believe that?
I believe in you, Elizabeth. In you, all things.
Space. The Alpha Registry master file.
Intact?
Yeah. No signs of corruption.
Then what are you waiting for? Copy the file.
With this, I can restore the registry at the hatch inside Allmother. Open it. Go inside.
And grasp the secrets within. Who? Are you really so naive? There will be no who waiting for you there, Aloy. Whatever birthed you into the world was a what, not a who.
You bastard.
Oh no, I had a legitimate birth. It's you, Aloy, who are the creation of a machine. But what kind of machine and why? Why were you created? You need to get out of there. What you found is too valuable. You're too valuable.
Suitable death in mind for you, child. My entire life, I've always known one thing with prophetic certainty. That I was destined for glory as a great champion of the sun. Even when Jaron was murdered, even when Meridian fell, I never doubted my destiny. Until you came along. When I heard that you had survived, a doubt took root in my mind. As sure as the sun rises and falls each day, those I am bade to kill die. And yet I failed. How? Why? With each dig site you attacked, each loyal soldier you killed, this pestering doubt grew. It grew when High Priest Bahavas went missing. I kept thinking of the moment my knife pierced your throat. One twist, a simple tug of the blade, and you would have bled out. In slaughter, I am a practiced hand. So why hesitate? Why fail my destined purpose?
See that scar on your cheek? You didn't get to finish.
Yes, I remember. You fought well. For a savage.
His name was Rost, and he was a better man than you could ever hope to be.
The better man is the one who doesn't end up with his guts steaming on the ground. No. It wasn't him. I could have finished you before he attacked. But I didn't. This failing troubled my thoughts. Haunted every step. It was only when I captured you, down in that place, that I finally glimpsed the sun's design etched at length across the course of events. You were meant to survive that day on the mountain. Meant to interfere at dig sites and kill my men. Meant to eliminate High Priest Bahavas. Conversely, I was meant to capture you. Here. So that you might die as a sacrificial offering to the sun. Everything as it was meant to be. Predestined and preordained.
Some destiny. You're following orders, not some grand cosmic design. You're a puppet, with Hades yanking the strings, a pawn pushed around by larger forces. It'd be laughable if there weren't so much killing involved. Hades is an ancient machine, not the buried shadow of Karja myth. It doesn't care about Meridian. It wants to kill everything and everyone. And you are its dutiful slave.
I serve not the buried shadow, but the sun in shadow. All halves of nature joined to one cause. Shadow to sun, dark to light.
Do you really not hear how ridiculous that sounds? You've gone from serving an insane homicidal Sun King to an insane homicidal machine. You're moving down in the world, not up.
I'll remember those words as I watch your corpse burn. Whatever's left of it. You fail to grasp the point. As surely as you've been conquered, so has all doubt. And with certainty of belief comes unstoppable force.
Then come to the cage and put your faith to the test. See if things work out like you expect.
The circle has closed. Every element is in its proper place, exactly where it belongs. The errant beast, now caged, will serve her true purpose. A sacrificial animal. Oh, speaking of sacrifice, I forgot to tell you. After you crashed the Eclipse Network, I sent messengers into the east to rally the forces there and mount an invasion of the sacred land. I ordered every Nora killed. I was hoping to catch you there, but alas, it all seems to have been unnecessary.
Why butcher dozens of innocents for no gain? It's a waste of effort.
You're right. I won't even be there to enjoy it. In any case, I couldn't recall the order even if I wished to. Thanks to your destruction of the network, communication over distances is impossible. You not only doomed yourself, but an entire tribe. Do we not see the scorching judgment of the sun in these events? Your focus, such a powerful device, isn't it? And yet, so fragile. So you see, this time, I did not hesitate. The knife has already been twisted.
Faithful, rejoice! Our years in shadow are over. A new dawn trembles on the horizon. A new day soon to break. And when it does, the false Sun King will be dead, and Holy Meridian ours once more. In this, I have become an instrument of prophecy. All halves of nature joined to one cause. Shadow to sun, light to dark, night to day. Behold! Hold your seats! Can you not see the proof of the sun's blessing before your eyes? How else could shadows such as these prowl in broad light of day? Were they not approved by the sun and joined to our cause? Many years ago, to consecrate this great ring, the Radiant Chiron ordered many faithless crushed beneath the hooves of the behemoth. Mighty is the behemoth in the eyes of the sun, but it is mightier still, infused with the power of shadows. Let this one, who schemed and slithered, be the first to die! Let her be the first of thousands!
God!
Weapons are up on the platform. There's no way out of this room. Maybe I could use its strength against it.